Do you want to get more done in HubSpot and get in that state of flow so you can have maximum productivity? Well, task queues are the way to do that.
Welcome to HubSpot Hacks, where we help you get more out of HubSpot.
So there's a number of productivity experts that recommend if you can get in the same type of work, you can maximize your brain, you can maximize your productivity and your thinking and execution. Well, HubSpot queues allow you to group like tasks together, and then that's not only the best purpose. The other thing is it allows you to move easily through contact records associated with those tasks without having to bounce back and forth. Super, super helpful. Let's dive in and see how to use it. You're gonna find tasks in the sales dropdown here under tasks. And then we've got a couple tasks loaded in here, for example. Now you're gonna see at the top, we've got all the different ways to group our tasks. So if I was looking at just due today, overdue, upcoming, we'll talk about this ABC trade show here in a second. The most engaged, these are gonna be the tasks related to people that have the most engagement, and then tasks that have been completed. So to just show you what a task queue looks like, you're actually going to click on start five tasks. So there's no way to say start my queue, but let's go ahead and get in this start five tasks. So all five tasks that are loaded here are going to come up, and you'll notice that Leslie Nope from Parks and Rec is our first person we're gonna follow up with. Now I'm here in the contact record, so I should have all of the different information that I actually need in order for me to follow up with this person. So I might have notes, I might have emails, calls, tasks, again, anything I might need. Over on the left-hand side, I've got information. But if I wanna actually reschedule this, let's say today just isn't a good day because I know she's at a conference. So I'm gonna reschedule this for a future day, let's say 3 days from now, and I'll click save. Now by doing that right inside of this environment, it's done and I can proceed to the next task. So in this case for Michael, we're gonna say, you know what? I did follow up with him. I'm gonna log a call right here. We're gonna say called Michael and talked pricing. Okay, so I can actually then create a task to follow up, which I'm going to do. I'm gonna log and complete this task. I'm gonna select the outcome as connected. Call direction is gonna be outbound. And in this case, I'm gonna log the call and complete it. Perfect, now it's completed. I'm gonna click on next. Okay, so associate this task with a record. We actually don't have this follow up with Bob regarding marketing. So we're gonna find Bob here. This is what it was supposed to be associated to. We're gonna click on association here. And now I've got Bob's record here in front of me. So we're going to actually then just close out of this and we're gonna say, I wanna actually look at some other functionality and let's just say that I'm not gonna get to these tasks today. We're gonna skip. And then in this case, we're gonna click complete, back to tasks. Perfect. All right, so we've got four tasks here. Some of them were done, some weren't. And now I'll go back to this ABC trade show. So ABC trade show is a special queue that was made for follow-ups associated with the trade show. So that's actually what the queues are designed for, to group like tasks together so that you can get in that state of flow in addition to the functionality here in HubSpot. So let's say that I'm going to create a new task and I'm gonna say we need to follow up with, and we'll look at someone who's here in the system so I can just make sure that I'm doing this right. We've got a test contact here, Michael. And we'll say Michael is gonna be the person we follow up with. We'll say Michael, and this is all fake data. And we'll say follow up. Right now, because I'm in this ABC test queue, it'll actually show me that I'm in this test queue. But let's say that I'm putting in Michael as a different event. Let's say that I was at a different trade show and I wanna have a new queue. So I could call this XYZ trade show. And then his task will go under that specific one. We'll click on create and we'll see that all are here. We're going to go to ABC trade show. And then I've actually got one more queue that I can add and we're gonna need to refresh this. There we go. XYZ trade show and we've got Michael. Now, let's say that Michael actually has, he's in the wrong place. We're gonna change his queue. We're gonna move it back to ABC trade show and save. So now I've got everybody who needs follow-up, refresh, right here in the middle of ABC trade show. I can start two tasks and then everybody I need to follow up with from that trade show, again, just like it was before, I'm going through the record one by one. I'm not clicking task, record. It's all here in one place and I can choose to reschedule, complete it, skip it, or in this case, we will go ahead and reschedule this and then back to tasks. So that's it. That's how to use a task queue. That's how to use that task flow. It's gonna be really helpful as you're moving through those tasks, trying to stay in that state of flow so you can get the most amount of work done without toggling back and forth. For more tips, tricks, and how-tos, hit that subscribe button. Let me know if there's other things with tasks that you'd like to do, or maybe if you've tried it and what you like about it, post a comment below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week.